Hey guys, we are in the basement, and you might be wondering why all the games are covered up, and also, where are all the games? We are in the process of just kind of fixing up the basement, making it look a little bit nicer. You couldn't see this before because all the games were in the way, but these walls used to be white, and they had all sorts of old water stains and everything on them. The walls have been waterproofed and dry-locked previously, but I never got around to painting them, so I just did kind of a masonry, used a masonry paint by Bear, just got from Home Depot. Took a couple gallons, and I did like a darker gray up top, just to kind of give it a somewhat more finished feel. And as you can see, floor is a little bit wet. We washed and etched the floor. And all these gray spots here, this is all the spots where we filled in concrete cracks that were down here. So this slab of concrete's probably about 80, 90 years old. So it's an old 1919 bungalow. So the floor's old, but we filled in all the cracks, got it all prepped, washed it today, etched it, and we will be making the arcade look a whole lot nicer. As you can see, it's kind of a mess down here. Had to move all the games over to this side. So, they're all down here now. And these are the pinballs. All sitting in temporary storage for right now. But what we're going to be using is this Rustoleum Epoxy Shield I got off Amazon.com, and it's got really good reviews, so I'm gonna give it a shot. And they make stuff for basements, they also make stuff for garages, but I decided to get the industrial grade, so probably a little bit over the top, but I figured I'm only doing this once, and I'd like to get the best bang for the buck. It's $100 for the kit, covers about 300 to 400 square feet, so it's gonna be good for the one half of the arcade side of the room. It's a two-part kit. I've never done this before, so we're gonna do it tomorrow, and I'll have some video footage of after we put it down. I'm a little bit nervous about doing it, but it should be fine. I got the floor as clean as possible, etched and everything, so I've done my homework and done everything right. And as you can see, that's kind of what it looks like when it's done. It's got those little flakes that you can put down in it. But what I found was that you can get these also to go along with it. These are the normal ones that come with it. So we're gonna put those down. That should look good. But I'm also going to put these black light reflective paint chips down as well. So I'm gonna mix those in with the regular ones. And we're gonna get a couple of fluorescent black lights, and when the lights are out and the black lights are on, the arcade will glow a little bit. Should kind of have like a cool star effect. So should be pretty cool. Kind of excited about that. But anyways, we'll give you guys some footage tomorrow when we get it all done. Basement's still kind of drying out right now. We spent all morning getting it prepared. And we'll let you know how it goes. Alright, so thanks for tuning in, and I guess next you'll see what the finished product looks. Cross your fingers! Hey guys, well, as you remember, just a couple seconds ago when you were viewing, you saw the unfinished floor. We've also brought in the Dig Dug. That just needs get a cap kit on it. But here's what the floor was looking like. This side's obviously not been done because I had to move all the games. But I wanted to show you the work that we've done. So this is the new finished floor. So this is a two-part epoxy. We use Rustoleum, the professional grade. It's like a dark gray. It comes with these chips. But I think what really set it off was it also comes with you can purchase a high gloss clear coat epoxy to go over it, and it really adds that nice shine, as you can see. I don't have all the games completely set up yet. They're all in the row, but they haven't all been hooked up, so they're not all turned on. But did a little bit of a design change and moved a couple of the games over along here. It's a little bit dark over here, so it's gonna be hard to see. But we still gotta hang up all our signs and stuff like that. But we've changed it, so now the walls are a nice dark gray and painted there. And like I said, this is definitely an upgrade for the floor. That's the comparison. So, looked like crap before, but it really came out nice. So, anyways, just thought I'd share with you guys. It took us a long time. This is a lot of preparation. If you have an unfinished basement floor and think about doing something similar, I can't stress enough. Make sure you properly clean your floor, spray it down, wash it, spray it, wash it again until every ounce of dirt is up, and then get an etching solution, and you have to etch the floor. That kind of, it absorbs into the concrete, and the concrete's a chemical reaction so that the new epoxy paint will absorb into the paint, or into the concrete better. So it's a little bit pricey. It was about $100 for the paint, and then another $100 for the high gloss epoxy. But if you want something that hopefully is going to last, and this is kind of a higher quality than just, you know, painting your floor, definitely recommend it. So now we just have to do this side. You know, we'll get there. Anyways, talk to you guys later on. Hope you enjoyed the video, and shoot me a question if you have any thing you need to be answered, okay? Thanks a lot. See you in the next video.